In this update, now you can choose between Bitcoin network or Ethereum network to provide a billing and authentication capabilities to your application. Let's enable the use of Ethereum network. Just after you have completed the installation tutorial, go to the build settings and enable the preprocessor constant enable Ethereum. Next, you should remove the DLLs related with Bitcoin, since unfortunately they collide with Ethereum DLLs. Now you are good to go. If you run the application, you can use Ethereum network to complete a payment and apply your signature to the record using Ethereum smart contracts. If you want to use Bitcoin, let's go back to the build settings and enable the preprocessor constant enable Bitcoin. Next, remember to recover the end Bitcoin DLLs and remove the Ethereum DLLs. Now you can work with Bitcoin as we did before this update.